National Giant Sloth Champions, everybody.
It's really cool.
So you
it's
see,
awesome.
Here's their second run, like I was saying before. This is a long
cool,
GS course for next
accomplishment, I guess. It's
Christian
fun to get the GS title this time around and do it
and
with
that's
all these competitors
here. I didn't see what he did.
And you crossed the finish line with just one pole in your hand. What happened there?
I did. On the top flats, I hooked my arm and I got it back. The pole was not there. So skied kind of last three quarters of the course without the pole. But it wasn't so bad.
And there's quite a bit of competition between you and Phil and Eric and some of the other guys. What's it like to come out on top today?
I think it's a pretty good, friendly competition. For sure, a tight group of guys. And we're all fighting out here, charging and trying for the win.
I was actually pretty pleased with how I skied this morning, just a couple mistakes in the wrong spots. And then this afternoon I obviously skied pretty solid. The conditions weren't really ideal, so it was hard to sort of be better than others because the rough conditions, so it was hard to like make up time on people. But I skied well and I did what I could with what I had. And Trevor skied phenomenally this morning, so kudos to him for taking the win. I'm really happy for him, he's a good buddy of mine.
And JP Waugh's last day today with the team, and obviously he didn't race for any thoughts on him and what it's been like to have him on the team.
Yeah, it would have been really nice to win actually today because JP was a big mentor of mine, so it would have felt good to win on the day he's calling it a career. But we had JP around for the last 2 years with us, and he was teaching us little things on the road, just stuff from his experiences in the last 14 or 15 years, whatever it was. And you know, those things go a long way for us as young racers coming onto the World Cup, so those are very valuable lessons.
Yeah, I think the guys skied the way we expected them. Trevor definitely had a very good first run, and he did a pretty good skink in a second run after he got distracted and lost his pool. I think that was a real good attack, and congratulations to Trevor. I think it's
has gone off course.
His first title, so it's very important. I think Phil Brown skied as well as Trevor, but had a good day too. It's too bad for Eric that had a good first run and made a couple mistakes in a second run that he didn't finish where he wanted to. I have to say that a couple young guys from the provinces, Tyler Berry and Morgan McGarry, they did excellent job and they got into the mix, and I'm very happy that we have some guys behind the national team that will be our future.
And any thoughts today on JP, who kind of went down the first run in his regular clothes and said goodbye to all the coaches, and sort of an emotional day for him?
Yeah, I think it was an emotional day for all of us. It was a long run. JP was with the team for 14 years. I spent with him 10 years. And, you know, when you see somebody that is such a great person, such a great athlete, it's not just a racer leaving, but it's a friend leaving and actually moving on better, you know, new things. And the only thing I can say, hopefully he enjoys his family and all the best and all the luck in his future life.
Yeah, the coaches, the Dujan organized that I would start, I'll be a DNS for the race, but start after the number 15. So all the guys are at the bottom, in the top 15, when I was coming down. And it was great. I just skied my friend from when I was racing as a youngster, as a 6, 7, 8 until 15, 16 years old. Was following me with the GoPro, and I stopped at coaches and give hugs and thank yous and kept going to every coaches all the way down. My wife was with Dujan at the last coaching spot, and then we skied to the finish, and the guys all jumped on me and dogpiled on me. And so we took pictures and we had a great time. And after that, I skied all day. My feet are killing me right now. Muggles and ski boots, not always the best, but it's been awesome days. So I'm really happy with the way my retirement went. I had a lot of injuries, and it's not fun to be finishing on injuries. So to finish LT and everything, I think it's the best thing that I could finish my career with.
And did you think back today to your career a little bit and maybe get a little bit emotional?
I think it's more people that I'm not going to see that much anymore. But as my career, I'm happy with what I achieved. I think it's not just about the result, but it's about what happened to go to those results that made who I am today. And I'm proud of what I've been doing to get where I am today.
And you're excited about life after ski racing?
Oh yeah, for sure. And I have two kids. I'm sure they're gonna want to be racing, maybe not at the high level, but I will help them as much as I can if they want to.
Hey, 2013 slalom champions, everybody.
It was quite good. I took good advantage of starting number one in the first run. I really went for it, and I knew when I got to the bottom, I was like, that's going to be hard to catch. I think, you know, like when you just have one of those good runs. Second run was definitely softer. We had a later start, like a 2 o'clock start, so we were just waiting all day for the men to be done. And so it was like you just had to ski the rut, but yeah, it was fine, yeah.
And you're hoping to keep it rolling tomorrow?
Yes, exactly. And I came in this week and I was like, you know, that'd be the coolest thing if I can get 4 golds. And then on the first day, the first downhill, I was second. I was like, ah, you know, that crushes my week's the best result that I could ever have. But I'm so happy already. Like, this has been awesome.
Well, I thought she skied well, like she has all year. She was relaxed, nothing special, no mistakes, and stepped away from the field.
And some of the other girls, they have Routier in second and Ellie third.
Yeah, they did a solid day. A little bit far back than we'd like, but still they all sent it, and a couple of mistakes here and there cost them. And it was too bad that Aaron went out first running. I mean, she would have given Mitch a run for her money also.
And nice to see some of the younger girls fighting it out behind them, like Grenier and Tommy and other girls.
Large number of them. Very impressed with that crop coming up. There's five or six that really, really sent it in and stood out from the field. And that's what we need. We need a good, strong crew coming up for the next wave.